Good morning, students. Hope you're fine and safe. Students, today we'll do the part 2 of the second chapter, that is changes in neighborhood and school. Right? First, I'll get the pen from here. Now, let's move to the next slide. Students, let's recall what we studied in the last class. First, that everything changes as time advances. Right? As time passes by, everything changes. So there is a change in lifestyle, in food, in work, in clothes, in traditions, and in houses. And we learned what all changes happens in all these fields, right? In the last class, we learned, right? Now, we learn changes in a family. So, students, changes in a family, it takes place over time. Some family members, they move out to study, right? You must have seen that your cousins or your siblings, they move out to study or in search of better jobs, right? In search of better jobs. So, this way, the family structure changes. Now, some members grow old and some new members are born. Right? So this way, there is a change in a family structure. Now, let us understand what are the reasons because of which the family structure changes. First is changing school. Right? We'll understand this with the help of this example. Suppose, her name is Kim and he's her father. So one day, Kim's father received a letter from his office and the letter said that he was being promoted and would have to move to another city. So when Kim's father showed the letter to the family, everyone was surprised. And now Kim will have to shift to a new place. She'll be shifting to a new place and leaving behind her grandparents as her father has been transferred there. This is not just the example of Kim, students. It happens with many children. Because of their parents' transfer, they have to move to the new city and because of that, they have to leave their grandparents in the hometown. So, with change in place, also students, when the parents get transferred, the kids also have to change the school, right? Now, they have to go to a new school. And because of that, in the new school, everything is different. Her friends are new there, teachers are new there, the school environment is new. So, it gets little hard to adjust in a new environment. And so, one reason we have studied that what are the reasons because of which a family structure changes. It is that when a father gets transferred or when the parents move to the another city, changing school. Now, the next reason is changing classroom, right? So, when class section changes and friends can get scattered in different sections, children find it little difficult to adjust according to the new change. You might have experienced this, students, that when your friends or near ones, they are shifted to another section. For few days, you feel little sad, right? Little lonely. But with time, we get adjusted. So this is a case study that Anuradha is an anxious parent. Her daughter, who was in section A of class 2 last year, is now in class 3B. While her parents are scattered in section A and C. So, okay students, it is not parents, it is friends. That while her friends are scattered in section A and C. So, because of that, now her friends are in different section and her daughter, Anuradha's daughter, she is in 3B. So that is why Mrs. Anuradha is little worried That's how her 8-year-old daughter will adjust to the new environment. Okay? Now, what are the effects of shifting? Right? What are the effects of shifting? We'll learn in this slide. So, when we move from one place to another, our family structure changes. Right? Movement from one place to another changes our family structure. So, and when the family structure changes, because of that, many of us now live in nuclear families and away from our grandparents and relatives, right? Nuclear families, we learned about nuclear families in the last chapter, right, students? Then the third effect of shifting is that moving of family also brings changes in the value, right? The values which we could have learned in a joint family, we don't get to learn that in a nuclear family. Like it is kind of difficult to inculcate the values of a joint family in a nuclear family children, right? Then fourth is sometimes change causes happiness, right? It is one of the effect that sometimes it brings happiness. How it brings happiness? When there is an improvement in the standard of living, right? When there is an improvement in the standard of living with better education. When you get better education, when you are admitted in a very good school, or when your parents get good job opportunities, then the shifting brings happiness. But at times, change causes happiness to students, as we leave behind our friends and families, right? So when we shift, we leave behind our friends and families, and that causes unhappiness. So these are the effects of shifting. Now, we learned about friends. Students, we all know that friends are important part of everyone's life, right? Friends help each other. They give each other strength, right? So, you must have also helped some of your friends in times of difficulty, right? And when your friend is sad or when he haven't scored the good marks, then you give him encouragement, you motivate them. So, that is called friendship. Now, some friendship rules to make new friends are share. First is share. So we should always share anything. It can be our food, it can be our stationery items, right? So this way we can make friends. Then be nice. We should always be nice to everyone. Be nice and be polite. Give flowers. Occasionally, students, you can also give flowers. Your friends will feel good. Then say please and thank you. Right? Show your gratitude always, students. Then play together. When you play together, you make more friends, more new friends. You should help each other. You should help each other. Then you should be fair. There should be no cheating between friendship. And you should always give compliments, right? If your friend have scored good, then you should say, "Are wow, good, nice, you've scored really well," right? And if some of your friend have participated in the sport activities and he secured second or third position also, then also you should give him a compliment. Give him or her a compliment, right? Now, students, since this chapter is all about change, so you must be thinking that whether change is bad or good. Students, let me tell you that change is good because it helps us to grow and learn, right? It helps us to grow and learn. Change creates environments in our lives and it is an important part of our life. So, we can say that change is good, right? But it is never easy. It is never easy. Then, since we know that it is not easy, so how can we adapt or adjust to change? How can we adapt or adjust to change? First step is that we should accept the change. We should not be reluctant of the change, or we should not be hating that thing, that why it has changed. We should accept the change because life is not static and change is a part of life. Then second, that how can we accept change? So the key to accepting changes is to have an open mind, right? Is to have an open mind. Open mind means having no grudges or something. So we should accept the change with an open mind and to accept everything it presents itself. Also, the third step can be that while adjusting to change, we should be patient, right? We should not hurry. Like, okay, since I've joined this new school, I want to get adjusted within one day. No, it is not possible. Change or adjustment to change always takes time. It might take you 1 week or 2 weeks. So you should be always patient, right? Then, fourth is give yourself time to change. Change happen overnight, but adjustment takes time, right? Changes can happen overnight, but adjustment, it takes time. So you should always give yourself the time to change. And also, during this change adjustment, family support is very important. So you should always seek for family support during this changing period. Now students, now we are coming on to the next topic, that is gender inequality related to play. First of all, let us understand what do we mean by gender inequality, right? There are two types of gender, men and women. And let me tell you, gender is a social construct, right? So gender inequality, it refers to health, education, economic and political inequalities. So in what all fields inequalities are there? In health, in education, in economic, and in political fields, inequalities are there. So, gender inequality refers to health, education, economic, and political inequality between men and women in India. Okay? Between men and women in India, there is less equality and more of inequality. And this inequality is in the field of health, right? Then education. Many girl child does not get proper education, whereas the male child is always preferred or always sent to the school for getting education. Then in economic wise also, you must have seen that many of the ladies, they work at home only, they are homemaker, and thus they have less money in their hand, whereas the men, they work outside and they get their salary or income. So thus they have more income in their hand, more salary, more money in their hand. Then political inequalities, right? In politics also, when we see the figures, when we see the statistics, there are very less women who represent in the parliament, right? There are very less women leadership. Most of the political leaders are men. So we can see that there are so many inequalities between men and women. For example, sports, right? Sports have always been identified with men. Women are not encouraged to actively participate in sports. Right? In India, women are not encouraged. They are basically encouraged to do the household chores and not encouraged to actively participate in sports. The condition of women who take up sports are subpar when we compare it to the foreign countries' women. Right? But students, now the trends have changed. Many females in sports have made our country very proud and they've also earned fame. For example, MC Marie Kom. She is the first lady boxer to have bronze medal at London Olympics for India. Right? So she is MC Marie Kom and she has won bronze medal at London Olympics for India, and she was the first lady boxer to win that from India. Then second example is Mithali Raj. So this is her photo and she's ranked number one by the ICC World Women's Cricket Rating, right? So you can see that how our females are making us proud. Then third example is Geeta Fogat. She is an Indian wrestler, right? And she is the first sportswoman from India to have qualified for the Olympics. So, these are just few examples. We have many more examples, students, right? Then, in the last slide, we learned gender inequality related to play. Now, this is gender inequality related to work. Now, students, in this slide, we'll learn gender inequality related to work. So, in the work culture also, in old days, the jobs of men and women, they were clearly demarcated that the women will do the household chores whereas the men will do the outside works. And few jobs like army, air force, pilots, police were reserved only for men. But today, students, women are also venturing into all these fields, right? They are also taking up these jobs. They are working as doctors. Here you can see she's a lady doctor. Then you can see they're working as doctors, scientists, pilots, and even astronauts, right? She's an astronaut and they are pilots. They are fighter pilots. And we've also seen women as auto drivers, train drivers. So you can see that she is the first lady driver of Mumbai, right? Auto driver of Mumbai. So now the scenario is changing. And also, not just women are taking up the jobs which were not in the traditional category. Now, the men have also stepped out of the traditional fields and have joined professions like fashion designing, makeup artist and chef. See, you can see that he is a makeup artist, right? And he is a fashion designer and he is a chef. So, students, we can say that we should never demarcate that this is men's job or this is women's job. All the work can be done by everyone. Everyone has the potential to do the work, to do any work. And we should never discriminate or demarcate, right? And whatever work we are doing, we should excel in that. For example, students, I would like to give the examples of Sunita Williams and Kalpana Chawla. They both are astronauts. And Sunita Williams, she was the only woman astronaut who stayed in space for 165 days. So, earlier this was considered, the astronaut job was considered just for the men. But you can see that she has also bravely you know, taken up this job and she stayed for 165 days. So, any job, I just want to convey this student that any job can be done by anyone, right? Then Kalpana Chawla, she was an astronaut who met with a heroic death in one of the space assignments. So, they both are from India, Sunita Williams also and Kalpana Chawla also. But unfortunately, we lost Kalpana Chawla in a while she was returning from a space assignment, right? So with this student, we come to an end of chapter 2, that is changes in neighborhood and school. So I would just like to conclude, students, that in the first slide we learned about the reasons for change, in the family structure. First was changing school and second was changing classroom. Then, what are the effects of shifting? We learned about that. And how can we adapt to change? Then, we learned about gender inequality related to play and then gender inequality related to work. Okay, students? So, I hope there's no doubt. In case you have any doubt, you can just message me once, right? Thank you, students. Be healthy and be safe.